So we let us start the class today, and today's class we will be continuing with the previous story. So from your Beehive, open page number 115 from paragraph number 12 we are starting. So till now we have read the story that Bruno, such a big feeder, he eats almost everything, he drinks anything which is liquid, and already two disasters like that happened. One is the barium carbonate and another one is the old engine oil. Now the next part. The months rolled on and Bruno had grown many times the size he was when he came. He had equaled the Alsatians in height and had even outgrown them, but was just as sweet, just as mischievous, just as playful. So Bruno's size, now he came to their home as a baby. Now he is no longer a baby. He has like doubled and tripled itself according to the size. And the Alsatian dogs, you know, the Alsatian dogs are huge in size, so it has exceeded their size as well. But by nature, Bruno was a very playful, a mischievous, and a very sweet creature. Okay. Page number 115. So Bruno, by nature, though by the structure he was huge, he was becoming huge, he was having the monstrous figure, but by the nature and by the temperament, he was very sweet, just as mischievous as playful. He was very fond of us all. Above all, he loved my wife and she loved him too. So Bruno loved everyone, especially the wife, the narrator's wife. Okay, as she loved Bruno a lot, Bruno also loved her a lot. Okay, she was the favorite. She had changed his name from Bruno to Baba, a Hindustani word signifying small boy. So normally when we refer to any small kid, especially a boy kid, with a very loving tone, in a very loving tone, like especially the mothers or the grandmothers or like the family people, out of too much of love, they sometimes refer to their child as Baba. So here Bruno, now this narrator's wife, she no longer calls him by the name Bruno, but it got converted into a very loving tone, that is Baba. And he could do a few tricks too, and Bruno had learned to do some, you know, activities, some kind of, you know, like play. So what kind of play? So at the command Baba wrestle or Baba box, he vigorously tackled anyone who came forward for a rough and tumble. So if anyone is telling Bruno that Baba box or Baba wrestle, then he will immediately get the instruction what he is being asked to. So he will get into the fighting mode and he will like vigorously like throw his hands like kind of as if like he's really fighting. Okay. Give him a stick and say, Baba hold gun. So just give him a stick and if you command him, Baba hold gun, then he pointed the stick at you. Ask him, Baba, where's the baby? So if you give him the stick and tell Baba hold gun, he will hold the stick and it will point at you. Means like holding like a gun. Okay, it's his way of understanding what it is. And then if he's asked that, Baba, where's the baby? And he immediately produced the cradled affectionately a stump of wood which he had carefully concealed in his straw bed. But because of the tenant children, poor Bruno or Baba had to be kept chained most of the time. So now, when again like it has been asked to him, Baba, where's the baby? So he need to show the baby, and how he will show the baby? He will bring some wood pieces and he will bring it in such a way as if he is holding a baby, cradling it in a very affectionate manner. Okay, and he will be hiding those woods in his straw bed. Now, because of the tenant's children and because Bruno is no longer the small, cute bear, okay, he is like a grown-up bear, he is almost a grown-up bear. So, for safety reason, Bruno had to be chained up, okay, so that there should never happen any kind of casualty, especially with the children of the tenants. Then my son and I advised my wife, and friends advised her too, to give Baba to the zoo at Mysore. Then, like, people started advising her. Now, in the people, narrator is there, narrator's son is there, even the friends are also there. So they all started advising the lady that you need to give away Bruno. Means Bruno is big enough, now you need to send him at its right place. That is the zoo of Mysore. After some weeks of such advice, she at last consented. So it has been like, she had been like told this thing repeatedly weeks after weeks. So finally she just said yes. So as soon as she said yes, hastily and before she could change her mind, her letter was written to the curator of the zoo. She just happened to say, okay, fine. Immediately they all started preparing to send the bear to the zoo. So they immediately wrote letter to the curator asking him if they are willing to take the animal or not. Okay, a tamed bear. So obviously the zookeeper was much delighted to have that. So they also sent the cage, and in a lorry the bear was transported to Mysore Zoo. A letter was written to the curator of the zoo. Did he want a tame bear for his collection? He replied, yes. The zoo sent a cage from Mysore in a lorry, a distance of 87 miles, and Baba was packed off. We all missed him greatly, but in a sense, we were relieved. My wife was inconsolable. She wept and fretted. For the first few days, she would not eat a thing. Then she wrote a number of letters to the curator. How was Baba? Back came the replies. Well, but fretting, he refuses food too. Now, after Bruno has been sent to the zoo, it's a natural thing that he will be missed in the home. People missed him. But regarding this lady, narrator's wife, she was inconsolable. Now, others were relaxed that, okay, fine, the tension is gone, like, we don't have to worry now too much about what will happen to him and all. But regarding the narrator's wife, she was having a different kind of bond with the bear. So she was not able to come out of that grief. Okay, and she kept on feeling depressed. She did not eat properly. Then she started writing letters to the zoo curator. And she started asking about how her Bruno was doing. So she also got the reply that Bruno is well, but fretting, and he refuses food too. Fretting means he is being depressed. Okay, he is showing depression and he is not eating. Now see, he refuses food. Bruno is refusing food. Bruno, who will eat almost everything in the world, now he is refusing food. Okay, so the matter will be very serious, should be very serious. But that friends visiting Mysore were begged to make a point of going to the zoo and seeing how Baba was getting along. They reported that he was well but looked very thin and sad. All the keepers at the zoo said that he was fretting. For 3 months, I managed to restrain my wife from visiting Mysore. Then she said one day, I must see Baba. Either you take me by car or I will go myself, by bus or train. So I took her by car. So then, thereafter, whoever is going Mysore, the friends and families, okay, whoever is going Mysore, they will be requesting those people that if you are going Mysore, you please make a time to visit the zoo, because they wanted recent updated information of Bruno, how he is doing in the zoo. So they got the information that Bruno is fine. The only thing that he became very lean, he became very thin, and he looked very sad. Now for 3 months, the narrator's wife was restrained, means controlled, from visiting the zoo. The narrator did not allow the wife to go to the zoo because he was very sure that if he goes to the zoo, she won't be able to control herself anymore. So for 3 months, it was possible for him to restrain her. Then after that, she one day said that she need to see Baba. Now either he fix the tour means he take her by the car or she will go there by herself. So the narrator understood that wife, now we can't change her mind. So he took her in his car. Friends had conjectured that the bear would not recognize her. I had thought so too, but while she was yet some years from his cage, Baba saw her and recognized her. He howled with happiness. She ran up to him, petted him through the bars, and he stood on his head in delight. So normally friends, all they said, okay, they said that you are going there, but you, after all, he is a wild animal. He will forget you. He won't recognize you. Okay, so they started commenting in that way. Even the narrator also thought that maybe like he would have forgotten them. But as soon as this lady was nearby the cage, nearby Bruno's cage, Bruno immediately recognized who it was, and it was delighted, it was happy, it started clutching the bars of the cage. For the next 3 hours, she would not leave that cage. She gave him tea, lemonade, cakes, ice cream and whatnot. Then closing time came and we had to leave. My wife cried bitterly, Baba cried bitterly, even the hardened curator and the keeper felt depressed. As for me, I had reconciled myself what I knew was going to happen next. Now the closing time of the zoo is there, so they need to close the zoo, so that means that time is up, visiting times are over, so she need to leave Bruno. So she started crying. Okay, Bruno started crying. Watching that emotional scene, everyone started getting emotional. Okay, even the hard curator, who normally won't get emotional, he got emotional. And now the narrator, he understood what is going to happen next. He already expected that. Oh, please, sir, she asked the curator, may I have my Baba back? So that is what he expected, the wife is going to say. She went to the curator and asked that, may I have my Baba back? She wanted back her Bruno. Hesitantly, he answered, madam, he belongs to the zoo and is government property now. I cannot give away government property, but if my boss, the superintendent at Bangalore, agrees, certainly you may have him back. So he said, like, right now, madam, we can't give him back to you because he is the part of the zoo. He is a part of government property. You can't just take the government property. If you really want to take him, then you need a special permission from the superintendent. Okay, and the superintendent lives in Bangalore. So you please get the permission from there. He only can make that happen. Then followed the return journey to Bangalore and a visit to the superintendent's bungalow. So they came back to Bangalore and they went to the superintendent's bungalow. A tearful pleading. So she started crying in front of the superintendent. Baba and I are both fretting for each other. Will you please give him back to me? So she started crying, begging that please, like, we two can't stay away from each other. We miss each other. We are depressed without each other. We are fretting without each other. So please give him back to me. He was a kind-hearted man and consented. So this person, he was a good man. He was a kind-hearted man and he immediately agrees. Not only that, but he wrote to the curator telling him to lend us a cage for transporting the bear to Bangalore. So he not only agreed to give back Bruno, but he also took care of all the arrangement of carrying Bruno, of transporting Bruno from the Mysore Zoo to the narrator's home. Back, we went to Mysore again, armed with the superintendent's letter. Baba was driven into a small cage and hoisted on the top of the car. The cage was tied securely and a slow and careful return journey to Bangalore was accomplished. So, with full of confidence, finally they went back to the zoo, Mysore Zoo, with the letter of the superintendent, and they packed Bruno in a cage, okay, and properly placed it on the top of the car, and very carefully they drove the entire way back to Bangalore. So the mission was successful of bringing back Bruno. Once home, a squad of coolies were engaged for special work in our compound. An island was made for Baba. It was 20 feet long and 15 feet wide and was surrounded by a dry pit or moat, 6 feet wide and 7 feet deep. A wooden box that once housed fowls was brought and put on the island for Baba to sleep at night. Straw was placed inside to keep him warm, and his baby, the gnarled stumps, along with his gun, the piece of bamboo, both of which had been sentimentally preserved since he had been sent away to the zoo, were put back for him to play with. Now, a proper arrangement has to be done where to keep Bruno, because Bruno need a proper setting. You just can't keep Bruno in home like other pet animals. So they had a compound, so they made a structure in the compound which looks similar to the structure of the zoo. Okay, there will be a kind of ditch all around the place. Okay, dry moat. Okay, means Bruno will not be able to come out from that easily, so it will be a safety for everyone else, and Bruno will be near to his home. So a kind of thing was constructed. So descriptions are given here what kind of thing constructed. And not only that, all his playing items like the stumps which he considered to be his baby and he will be cradling and playing with it, so everything was kept by the lady as kind of memory of Bruno in a sentimental way. So those all were brought to him, okay, so that he will have them back and he can play whenever he feels like. In a few days, the coolies hoisted the cage on the island and Baba was released. He was delighted. Standing on his hind leg, he pointed his gun and cradled his baby. My wife spent hours sitting on the chair there while he sat on her lap. He was 15 months old and pretty heavy too. So now Bruno, after the island got ready for Bruno, Bruno was sent to that island, means island on the compound island, not far away. Okay, just beside the house, the island. So Bruno was very much delighted. He started playing with his gun, cradled his baby. Everything was coming back to normal. So the wife started spending a lot of time with Bruno, and Bruno will be sitting on her lap. Now sitting on her lap, Bruno is quite heavy right now. He is 15 months old, and as a 15 months old bear, he is very much heavy. But in spite of being a heavy creature, he was allowed to sit on her lap. The way my wife reaches the island and leaves it is interesting. I have tied a rope to the overhanging branch of a mango tree with a loop at its end. Putting one foot in the loop, she kicks off the other to bridge the 6-foot gap that constitute the width of the surrounding pit. The return journey is made the same way, but who can now say that a sloth bear has no sense of affection, no memory, and no individual characteristics? So the pit was designed in a way, and also like reaching inside the pit, especially when the wife will be going to feed or going to play with Bruno, she will be having a kind of mechanical thing like with ropes and all. Okay, so a kind of folding bridge was created, which she have to use her legs to open, and it can again get folded up. So some kind of system was arranged so that she can easily go and come out of it. But now the interesting fact is, apart from all these things, she got Bruno, Bruno got her, everything is like fine, happy ending. But the surprising element for the narrator here, he wanted to say that he now believed that any animal, whether it is a wild animal or a ferocious animal, if you are given a lot of love, if you give that particular animal a lot of love, okay, it can become a part of your family. Okay, it can become just like your kid. Okay, so he's telling that, but who can say now that sloth bear has no sense of affection? So it is a sloth bear, but the sloth bear loves the wife so much that they started crying for each other. He forgot his food, the food that he loves so much. He has forgotten the food when he was sent away to the Mysore Zoo. So see the level of affection that a sloth bear can have. So people who tell that sloth bear is not having any kind of affection, so they are wrong. They don't know the thing. And not only that, memory, they have a very good memory. He still remembers how he used to play with the gun, how he used to cradle the stumps as a baby. Okay, he remembers everything. And regarding the characteristics, well, Bruno has his own charming characteristics. He was very playful, he was very mischievous, and he was quite a fun. So he has his own character as well. Okay, so everything is possible if only if you provide love. So this is the chapter Bond of Love. Okay, so chapter is over here.